So guys, welcome to Borderlands, the pre-sequel. Claptrap just had an accident behind me. For those of you unfamiliar with Borderlands, this is the third installment of the game. I played Borderlands 2 on my channel a long time ago. I'm going to kind of walk you through what's going to happen right now. I just played this with Athena. That's who I'm playing with now. They're letting you... I'm at the 2K Studios, and they're letting us play like Mission 5 or 6 over and over. So I just beat it once, just to kind of get a feel for it, and now I'm going to try to make a good video. So hopefully this little speed run works. We'll see what happens. But there will be dialogue.
This used to be Sarpedon's own ship, you know? Before she got promoted, I mean. They say it went down before the crappening happened. Imagine that. Crash! Bang! Oh, would have been something to see.
Hey!
John, I want an update on the Helios situation.
Sir, I've got my best people working on a way to retake the station.
That's the Hyperion CEO. Is he as much of a bottle and glass arse as I hear?
Who the hell is that?
That is the 10-year-old boy we hired to help us.
Fire, John.
So you actually work alongside of Handsome Jack. I think his name's Handsome Jack. I'm trying to not look like a noob right here. I will for a little bit, I'm sure. There'll be moments. I'll do some transition work. Right now, I'm just trying to kill these guys. This game does take place primarily on the moon, as far as I know. Or at least the section we're getting allowed to play. Hang on, let me just kill this guy really quick. Now, the melee. Okay. Now, I'm playing as Athena. Her melee and her special is probably not near as good as Wihlem's or Nisha's. I think Nisha's is probably the most badass. I'll have to show you all this eventually. I'll kind of base it, if this video does well, you can expect more footage. Otherwise, I'll just probably play the game when it drops. I think it's October, maybe? I'm not sure. But yeah, I'm getting to play this a little bit early. I thought it was really cool they let us do this. I got to play Evolve yesterday. So I'm trying to kind of get used to it. They both have the jetpacks and stuff, so there's some similarities here and there. I'm trying to get past these little points without looking too bad at this game. We're kind of on a time crunch. I wanted to try to get as far as I can, and I was surprised I was able to beat what they gave us. I think the first time it took me about 45 minutes. This time it might be closer. I don't know. I might can shave 10 or 15 minutes off. We'll have to see what happens now that I know where to go. All these little security things pop out. I haven't leveled up her character yet. I will in a minute when I get to the next little area. Just trying to collect some more stuff right now. But yeah, thank you so much for all the support on anything you drop on this video. All the likes, everything really is greatly appreciated. This damn turret is killing me. The recoil, I'm not used to it. Just played Evolve yesterday and there's certain things that are just like it. Let me get this one first. Oh shit! That guy jumped right in front of me. Oh, time to go! Oh, I'm about to die. Are you shitting me? Oh, come on, man! What is that? One time for me. There we go. Second wind. They brought it back. Alright, sorry for the transition. I'm guessing there will be one. Sometimes as I'm recording, there'll be people leaning in talking to me. Oh, this is just like Borderlands 2. It's so like it's so much smoother, I feel like. But the way the setup is, they didn't have to change much. The health is still the same. I think Wihlem is probably the easiest character to use. I had a speed run with him earlier. I think I beat this whole mission in like 12 or 15 minutes. I don't think I'm gonna do it this fast this time. So her special ability is the shield. I'm just kind of going through everything really quick. I primarily kind of divided everything instead of going down the column. I knew that I wouldn't get to save this data. So I just kind of put on whatever I could find. I'm reading all the stuff right now. I think I just kind of plow through and just spend everything I can. I'm not really sure what else to put this on. At 12, let me just go ahead and... Let me just go ahead and get some of these ones really quick. Yeah, we'll just kind of divide it. All right, I think that's good. I don't have any more anyways. So I got the badass rank earned. The one thing I didn't do, I really didn't care to do, was just like using all the badass rank stuff. I didn't do that in this video. Primarily because, I don't know, I just didn't really feel like it. So I was just like just in a hurry to try to finish it. And I kind of wanted to do a little speed run without taking too much time. This shit is crazy. Does so much damage. Moonstruck, bitch. The hardest problem with Athena is the health. I think Wihlem has the two bots that follow you around, and it kind of shows you everything. It one protects you, one helps your shield, and they both attack at the same time. So here's her special. This is all she's got. And after she's done, it's basically just kind of protects you from getting hit for a minute if you're facing them. But as you upgrade it, you can actually see where it'll... They'll kind of have where the shield will ricochet off of all the enemies and stuff. Let me just get up there to them. You kind of will get a taste for the story as well. Oh, shit. Yeah, the story itself is pretty strong, though. I thought it was really cool how they implemented some of the characters. You got Handsome Jack, who was the bad guy. Now, you're not really a good guy in this one. You're kind of alongside the bad guys, but it's a pretty cool element to it, I think. So far, so good. Alright, we've got to go to the command center. Let me go ahead and head over here. I just want to make sure I get everything first. I'm trying to collect everything I can so I have an easy time with the boss at the end. Now, they did have a lot of weapons. The ones they start you out with are not the best ones they have on the list. So I went through and kind of changed some stuff up here and there.
I'm the captain of this vessel, and you, squalid looter, will soon face my wrath. Actually, as I've just blocked a path to my wrath, you'll face my men's wrath instead. My girlfriend and I will enjoy watching you from the safety of the captain's chamber. Won't we, my luscious snuggle bunny?
Yep.
We've talked about this, my love. You're to address me as baby or my dear, especially in front of the others.
Of course, my dear Bosie.
Mateys, attack!
Alright, watch how badass this rocket launcher is. Super badass outlaw my ass. So sick.
Hey there, sorry about all that. Look, I'm not really with Captain Arscrack here. To prove it, I'll pop the door for you. If you want that force field down, you need to go to the engine room.
All right, lady, but I'm watching you.
Listen, the bosun's pretty much holding me prisoner and making me do things for his entertainment, but you're here and you look like the rescuing type.
They're a flipping vault hunter, so they're more the ass-kicking type.
Kinda the same thing in my book.
Sorry, my mission is to retrieve a military AI.
Perfect. I know exactly where you can get an excellent military AI. Just come find me. First, I'll have to show you how to shut down the bosun's barrier.
Reckon she's onto something.
I'm not comfortable with this, but okay.
Great. I'll try to help along the way where possible, but I can't let the bosun know we're working together. So, sorry in advance for anything I have to do. I'll be in touch when you get to the engine room.
Alright, so I kind of cut to where I get to this next area. I was just kind of running around, and sometimes I'll let the dialogue play out. But chances are, if I do play the full game, I guess I'll just kind of see how this video does. If I play the full game, I'm not sure which character I'll use. But I will say I'll probably either pick Athena. I don't know, Wihlem is just like easy mode. Regardless, you'll be seeing other people play as them. This little area is pretty intense. You get a few run-ins here and there with the enemies, but they gave us an option to do single player, which is what I'm doing now, or do multiplayer. But they said since you're such a high rank, and some of the guys that were there with us hadn't actually played Borderlands before, They said we probably should do single player because as you play two-player co-op, three-player, four-player, however high it goes, it just gets more and more difficult because of the enemies.
Sorry about this, but I'm going to have to defend the engine room for the bosun, and these old Dahl Sams are tough.
Alright, so right now we're just making our way across. I thought it was weird to kind of go from playing Evolve, a heavily focused multiplayer game, and then they had this setup to where we just do single player. That poison gun is so sick. But if I wind up playing the full game, you'll probably see me replay this part of the game again. I don't know how I'm going to do it. I'll probably just either transition around it or do something. Because this looks like just a... They took a chunk out of the game and said, here you go. Play this. Oh shit, I'm getting shot at.
Nothing can get through my shield.
Her ability is just like so weak compared to the other ones. Now, Claptrap is probably the most hilarious because he... Hang on, let me throw this. Get a little closer. Bitch! There we go. Little Sam turret. Oh, I love the freeze ability. It's just like Borderlands 2, you put like all the different elements on your guns and stuff. And if you do the butt bump, which is where you, like, they just did it to me. Oh, guy's too short, I can't get him. Uh-oh. Oh, that's so sick. So sick. Little transition. You didn't miss much. Just me getting to the next area. Sometimes I'll get lost and I'll just kind of cut around it. I just basically cleared all the enemies out. You didn't miss much. I'm gonna get to this little next spot. There is the boss. Now, the guy that was talking to the woman who's trying to help you, his assistant or whatever, she's assisting you through this mission. And he's actually the boss of this as well. Look at these graphics.
Get your peepers on that! Hello there, shiny converter! Fancy meeting you here!
Don't take that, kid. It's not yours.
What? Stop it, my fluffy koalinid! The tiny feeble rat crushing, burning!
Calm down, dear. I'm doing my best. I'm not. This is fun.
Alright, this part is absolute chaos, guys. You got turrets, you got guys hopping out of the woodwork. What I was trying to tell you, though, was that I'm playing this on a pretty high-end PC. I'm not sure the brand or anything, but I'm playing with a 360 controller. But yesterday, I played Evolve on a high-end PC with an Xbox One controller, so I'm not really sure why they changed it up. Maybe it's not really compatible with this? I don't know why they did that. Regardless, that's not really the point. Point is, this game is badass so far. Oh shit. Come on, man. This melee just. Oh, I'm about to get killed. This is so sick. Now Claptrap actually has stuff where he can. I can't stand these turrets. The whole time I struggle with these. It's just like the last game where certain characters had health abilities, certain characters don't. I forgot who I played as in Borderlands 2. I'm sure she's in the thumbnail. I think I did it somewhere right there. I was kind of disappointed when this game wasn't going to be put on next gen, but PC is probably what I'll be playing it on anyways. I just like the console. I've always preferred them. So I don't have to worry about my game system getting a virus or something. Those rocket launchers do not play. Oh, come on, man. Let me just get closer. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. I think I fell. Oh, am I good? Am I good? I love the jetpack ability. Since you're primarily on the moon, the whole zero gravity thing, it does feel... It kind of has that Halo-ish feel a little bit. Where you kind of never really take fall damage and all that. It does have the drop-in, drop-out co-op. I think that's what the guy was telling me a minute ago. Basically, I'm playing this and I have people all around me. People that designed the game, watching my every move, so, like, the extra pressure's on. If I mess up, they're all over. I'm having a hell of a time, though. Come on, man, do some more damage. There we go. Those grenade kills are so sick. What I got, like, corrosive stuff going on right now? All right, I just did a little butt stomp right there. It's where you jetpack up and then you come down and just splash.
Hey, kid, are you sure this place actually has a combat AI? These pirate dick bags just sound nuts. Get it? Dick bags? Nuts?
Word is, before the bosun went native, he was some kind of AI tech whiz. Not that you'd think it now, he's gone all mum and dad mad. But what do you care? Didn't you just get fired?
And when I march up to Helios with an army of badass robots, I'll be unfired so quickly it'll make Tassiter's pedo mustache spin off his big gross ugly face. Just get the AI core.
Okay.
We can bring down the force field blocking your route to, well, me, by jettisoning the main engines. Removing them will really mess up several of the Drakensberg's key systems. I'll quietly talk you through things and update your echo where appropriate, but the bosun's going to throw a lot of his men at you.
Nothing I can't handle.
First, head to the engine control panel and set the ship's engines to maximum output.
Alright, this part of the game, I remember this part, is absolute just nuts. They, after you clear out the enemies, there's so much to do, so I might skip around a little bit. We'll just have to see what happens. Here they come. This shit's already happening. You guys remember the lunatics. Come on, man. There we go. I'm gonna try to squeeze this whole mission into one video. I feel like it's been close to 15 to 20 minutes now, and I feel like I still got another 10 or 15 left. So I'm hoping I can show all this in one video. We'll just see. Oh, that's so sick. A little jetpack. Like, the shield goes pretty far, but I don't have it leveled up near enough. Oh, take it. Oh, this is so sick, guys. Wait for it. Oh, I got it. The part of the grenade got him. This is my favorite gun just because I got that ice ability on it. And it basically freezes them every time. Now, just like the other Borderlands games, the objectives, everything, it's pretty straightforward missions. But I think really it's about leveling up your character. It definitely has that RPG feel like the last one did.
What's happening down there?
Nothing, dear. It's all under control. Great. Kid, can you find a way to the flow regulator if you know what that is?
Of course I know. Give me a sec.
My sniping is a little bit rusty. I do apologize. I'm gonna try to just kind of skip around and hopefully show you the meat of this. Look at that shit. Oh, I did kill her. Never mind.
There's a yellow button next to the red pipe. Push it.
There you go.
You know what to do, Vault Hunter.
Bring it! Oh, come on, really?
Bring the grill with you, Piper.
Sorry, I was like... If you hear me stop talking for a second, it's usually because someone also is talking to me, so I'm trying to do the best I can. All I know is, I'm gonna transition.
What the hell are you doing to my ship, Vault Hunter? And why haven't you dealt with them, my sweet?
Good work, that's done it. Now all you need to do is expose the power stabilizer. I don't understand it, love.
So right now we just basically are going doing different little objectives before we get out of this area.
Shoot it and we're almost done.
Oh, get there. Just like the last game, this, I mean, when you start getting swarmed with enemies, the stress just piles on you. It really does. Oh my goodness, come on, man, I got the rockets ready. Oh, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Second win. I gotta destroy that thing behind me. I'm gonna clear out the area first. I do think it's pretty amazing how it takes so long to level up once you get to like level 41. Like, I've killed so many enemies, and look at that little blue bar down there. It's like very minuscule. Holy shit. There we go. Alright, let's go back up here and destroy this thing. There we go. Yeah, you're supposed to jump up and shoot this.
Warning, ship's engine output at critical level, maggots.
I'll pull your brain out of your ears and dance on your skull with shoes made of acid.
And how are you going to put those shoes on? Honestly, you just blurt out threats without thinking. Good. Initiate the engine jettison sequence.
So this is actually where we're going. We're going to the last little area. As far as I remember, we're basically just going and we're going to be killing the last guy. We got to get this little room pretty much all locked down here in a minute. And then I think we go down through the center tunnel back there. I hope this is it. The last boss is not that difficult with like Wihlem, but with Athena, you really have to try.
Switching to crappy emergency power.
No! My lovely engine!
There. Strictly speaking, you didn't actually need to do that last bit, but I knew it would annoy him, so I thought, why not?
Job well done! You're on your own, Vault Hunter. I've got fresh loot to sort!
Head back to the core system room. We'll take care of the bosun's force field when you get there. The engine shaft's your fastest route.
All right, insects. This ends here. I'm sending in my best man to finish you off. He's called Poop Deck because he kicks so much ass. Get it? Get it? Well, you're gonna, sweetie pie, open up the door.
Alright, I'm gonna tell you right now, Poop Deck is probably one of the toughest enemies we'll have to ever face in a Borderlands game. I'm just letting you know now, I probably need to stock up on stuff. And this is not the final boss, this is the one before that, so here we go. Here he is. I like messing with you guys.
Oops, sorry. Did you want me to keep them open too?
What is wrong with you, my love? Poop Deck always had the nicest things to say about you.
Oh, I know.
I'm pretty sure that this has some of the best voice acting in any video game. I just don't see how anyone could have it like better. I don't know. This is the last area of enemies before the final boss. So we're just cleaning house right now, guys. Oh shit. So pretty much you're seeing, I wouldn't say it's the final game. Like, they're gonna do some more touch-ups, but if the game comes out in like a month or so, it's probably, you know, this is probably pretty close. I remember back when I played Watch Dogs, I played it like a month or so early. And it's basically the exact same, so I'm pretty sure at this stage of the game, it is what it is. You gotta lead those shots, baby! Alright guys, I've just been pretty much cleaning house. We're headed down to the last guy. Get some of this oxygen going. And we're actually going to the last room very, very soon. Gonna drop down a little bit first. Oh yeah, I skipped around a little bit here and there in this video just to kind of show you, I don't know, like the chunk that really mattered. A lot of the battles are just going to be endless. And I'll probably do the same thing with the full game if If this Vita does well, I'll probably like consider doing the full game and then kind of cutting around a little bit.
There, you can get to the command room now.
Know what, Vault Hunter? I want you to reach me! I want you to have my boot! My real one! Not made of acid, because I realize now that would be unrealistic. My boot crushing your mangy body to be the last thing you feel!
Better?
He's pretty much pissed at this point. He pretty much knows what's going on. Oh, this part gave me trouble the first time. This is actually the last little bit of enemies before you fight the boss. I mean, it's absolutely nuts, but I am wreaking havoc right now. This grenade, man, the grenades are helping so much.
You must understand, this measure is necessary.
All right, I have to get out of here, guys. I might just skip them. You don't have to fight everyone. Come on, grenades. Come on, grenades. As long as it does a little bit, I can pretty much get out of here while they're distracted. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Let's just get out of here. No time to waste, guys. I don't think I have enough to do anything in the shop, so I'm gonna just keep rolling. Alright, we're going to the last boss. We'll see how this goes. I had trouble, a lot of trouble the first time. Here he is.
Now, I'm really pissed off. Welcome to your death, landlubber.
Alright, so he's a level 37, so they were pretty generous to give us a level 41 character.
Yeah!
Problem is I have, like, no health right now, so if my shield drops, it's only a matter of time. Alright, it's got things that kind of help it charge, but I'm gonna try to just use this rocket. Gotta aim carefully, I don't have many left. Oh, it did so much damage. I've almost got him! Almost got him! Oh, so close! Oh, I got him! Shit, yes!
I'm out of- You need to come open this door now, Vault Hunter.
Alright, guys, we finally made it. I want to thank you guys for watching. And if you want to see the other characters, just let me know. Take it easy, guys.